If you need to approve contracts, payments, or other requests within your business, Pyrus may be the ideal solution for you. Let's take a closer look. Welcome to Pyrus. Pyrus presents itself as an excellent team communication tool, but I think its real strengths has to do when it comes to its task management and especially its workflow management when it comes to creating forms. But let's start with the basics. Here we are within our inbox, and this is really going to be your home base within Pyrus, because not only can you manage all of your own personal tasks or projects that you're working on with your team, but as you are assigned different steps or stages, as we'll look to a little bit later, they will also appear here. So you always know what is needed and where you should be focusing your attention. To create a new task in Pyrus, it's as simple as just hitting the new task button, and we're gonna send our weekly newsletter. That's gonna be the task in this case, if I can spell it correctly. And we can add as much description here as we want. Here are some of the additional bonuses of using Pyrus. Unlike other tools, we don't just have to make an assignment to an individual, we can also assign to roles. This is really, really powerful and flexible, because maybe you have more than one accountant, and it doesn't really matter which one it's assigned to, as long as they know they are at that stage and they need to approve it. The other nice thing is that we can create a workflow in the moment. So if I need to create beyond just subtasks, I can say who needs to approve those roles as I'm creating this task here. Another nice feature is that I don't have to just hit send, which is more than just complete or add, because really, when we're talking about workflows and forms, it's a process, right? So you're sending this to the next person in the stage, but I can also hit send and new. Okay, it's forcing me to select a person in this particular case. I'm gonna send it to the editor. I'm gonna say send and new. And so now I can immediately start filling in my next task or create my next workflow. But let's get out of our inbox here for a moment, because I think the real power within Pyrus is creating our forms and its associated workflows. So here we've got a few different examples here. We've got an accounts payable invoice, which is standard for really every business. As you're receiving invoices from vendors, who is approving those payments? Who's making sure that the numbers are correct and that you've got the right PO number, for example, and that you've got those things in place before you actually pay for that invoice? Or you may have something like a service desk form or a general inquiry form. As someone is making either a complaint or an inquiry, you want to have a certain step or certain procedures that people are following so that you can provide the best service possible. So let's start with this AP invoice. I'm going to click on it, and you'll notice that we'll have some of the more typical fields that you would find in an AP invoice. Now, everything that you see here is absolutely customizable. Things such as vendor, invoice date, PO number, and of course our invoice total. But probably the easiest way to add an invoice, rather than filling out all of these particular fields, is just to upload the invoice itself. We can either upload a file or paste an image of that invoice. So I'm gonna select upload a file here. I've got an invoice here that I'm gonna select, and I'm gonna say open, and it's gonna upload this PDF file. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna skip all the way down to the bottom, and I'm gonna hit send. Send is going to start this process and assign it to the next person in the stage. The reason why I'm going to do this is I'm gonna actually show you the form in just a second, because what Pyrus is doing is actually scanning the information in this particular invoice. It does have OCR technology built in. And as we scan down here on the left-hand side, you can see that it has actually brought in all of these line items, including things like the price, including things like the correct quantity. And I haven't had to type in any of this manually at all. It's just automatically brought it over here into my invoice details. If I scan down below, you can see it's also looking at the next steps in the process, because I've already set up a workflow for this particular form. So I filled in the form at this time, but now I've added the accountant to step two, and I've also added myself to step four. So I know exactly where this is going in the next step. Down below, you can also see the comment field is designed a little bit differently than what you would find in a standard comment field, because in these cases, we want to either approve, acknowledge, or maybe disagree. And yes, there are some quick keys you can use here as well. Is everything looking correct over here on the invoice, and is it matching up over here on the left-hand side? I'm going to go back for just a moment here and open up another invoice that we've taken a look at. I've got a few different invoices here that are currently in my queue. So let's take a look and see what we need to do next as a part of it. So here, if I scan down here, I can see that Bela filled in this form. And again, we have the same steps that are happening here. Accountant to step two and Scott to step four. Now, in this particular case, one of my roles is accountant. So I can come down here and select approve and hit send, but it's going to do a double check for me and say, well, wait a minute, the invoice total cannot be held blank here. Let's make sure that you fill everything in correctly here before we move on to that next step. So having all of these checks and balances built into your forms, built into your workflow, is exactly what makes things so powerful here within Pyrus. Now I'm going to actually go back to the forms for a second, and I'm going to click on AP invoice once again, but instead of filling out a new one, I'm going to come up here and show you both the dashboard and how we can configure those workflows. So starting with the dashboard, you can see there's an awful lot of great information we can take a look at. This is all of the info that we have related to this particular form. So we can see exactly where things are within their steps. I've got three invoices within the GL coding process, and two are currently being assigned to the controller at this point in time. And we can even see the quantity or the value of those invoices here as well. But we can also see things such as how much time has been spent on each of these steps, aging reports, due dates, overdue dates, a lot of different data here that we can analyze here for each of our customized forms. But let's go all the way over to our configure tab, because this is where you're going to start and make sure that your workflow is working the way that you want. Here you can see the four-step workflow that we've created here. I can select that option, and now we can start to customize all of the approvers that it needs to go through as a part of this step. And as I mentioned before, if I click on this area here, I can either choose an individual, including the original author, or I can choose a particular role, giving you that much more flexibility. I can even add additional conditions here as well in terms of, do they need to check a particular field, for example? Do they need to make sure that there is a PO number assigned before it can be passed on to the next step? You can add as many steps as you need here to making sure that it gets assigned to the correct role or to the correct individual as you go throughout this process. But let's go back to our forms builder one more time. And this time I'm going to click on the service desk form. Now I've created something that is much simpler. Why? Well, this is very different than approving an invoice. In this case, maybe someone is requesting time off or requesting a piece of equipment within my organization. So I've got things like subject and description, and maybe I want to make sure that they include their email and their phone number. But if I come over here to configure, again, where I want to focus a lot of my attention is making sure that my workflow is correct. So if I click on workflow, maybe I want it to be assigned to Bela here when it's first assigned, and then we can just assign to the person responsible. But if it gets escalated, I'd like it to come back to me. So I'm going to change that person here. I'm going to remove Bela in this case, and now it's going to come to me if this needs to be escalated. I can hit save, and in the future, I can know that if anything comes up with this particular form, what's going to happen is it's going to appear in my inbox. So I can come here, spend most of my time within my inbox, not only managing my own individual tasks, but making sure that I'm assigned to the things that I need to be working on based on preset workflows. Now, if you'd like to try Pyrus out for yourself, be sure to visit pyrus.com and start with their free forever version. Thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.